three-alarm fire has destroyed the St. Nicholas Church in Danbury.
Can't, you know, imagine that what I'm seeing in front of me. I mean.
June 29th, 2013. Disaster struck at St. Nicholas Church in Danbury, Connecticut. Few hours after the liturgy, a terrible fire broke out. It went up into the ceiling, and within a few hours, our beautiful place of worship was reduced to a pile of molten rubble and ashes. But a few days later, after this terrible fire, we saw signs of hope, signs that Christ was with us even during this dark period. As we entered the structure, we saw on the wall a crucifix. The cross itself was charred as it would be as a piece of wood in the fire. But the corpus on it was just painted plywood, was completely untouched. The body of Christ looked like it did before anything had happened. Yet it was attached to the cross that was ravaged by the fire. Also, on the altar sat the tabernacle which contains the most blessed body of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. During the fire, the molten ceiling fell on the tabernacle. The heat melted this brass box. And a few days later, we were able to take it out of the church. The fire was so hot that the key melted on the altar. Yet when we were able to open it with a spare key, we found inside the chalice containing the body of Christ, completely untouched, centered upright in the tabernacle. The tabernacle was lined with white silk. The white silk was unscathed by the flames and the heat. After we consumed the Eucharist, just an hour later, we went back and looked in the tabernacle and saw that the inside, which was pure white when we initially opened it, was now black. Not black from the flames, but black with mold and discolored spots. It appeared that after we consumed the Eucharist and it was removed from the tabernacle, the inside just deteriorated. Both of these items were signs of hope in this terrible and devastating time for us.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down.
June 28th of 2015, 2 years almost to the day after the fire, we had our first liturgy in our newly constructed church. And in August of that year, our bishop came and rededicated and blessed our new church.
We are now trying to preserve the signs that gave us hope through our most challenging hour. The cross, which has survived the fire, has been a symbol of that hope. We hope to incorporate the cross that survived into the cross of San Damiano, which in the 1200s spoke to St. Francis of Assisi. And Christ from the cross in that vision told St. Francis, "Francis, go out and rebuild my church, which as you can see is falling into ruin." And he went and answered the call of Christ and rebuilt the church of San Damiano. But then further, throughout his life and through his deeds, rebuild the church community, not only where he lived, but also throughout the world. And through creating this image and incorporating it with the cross of San Damiano, we hope to do just the same. We've rebuilt the church and spread the gospel throughout the world.